This is a very quick review of the SE-X1 condenser microphone. Now, I reviewed the USB version of this not that long ago, the SE-X1 USB, but I got an X1 to try. It's got pretty much all the same features as the X1 USB. It is the same microphone, just analog. It's got the roll-off switch, which, if I switch that on now, then that takes down the low frequencies a little bit. Good for rumble and stuff like that. And it's got a pad switch, which just decreases the volume by 10 decibels, pretty much. That's what it does there. It doesn't have the headphone output of the X1 USB because you're expected to listen to it through your mixer or audio interface or whatever else you're putting this into. This shock mount, it doesn't come with straight out of the box. This is from a separate isolation pack, which SE sell. They also sell it with a pop filter, and I think that's around £30. But it doesn't come with that out of the box. It just comes with a microphone clip like the X1 USB. And it's also cardioid, which means you have to speak into it through the front, like I'm doing now. If you speak into it from the side or from the back, I don't know how I'm going to do this, from the back, like that, then it's not going to sound good. Speak into it through the front and it'll sound lovely. And it's not switchable either. It doesn't have a switchable polar pattern thing. So this is what it sounds like without a windscreen. If I put a windscreen on now, that's what it sounds like with a windscreen. I think it does a pretty good job without the windscreen in comparison to other microphones, but obviously use a windscreen or a pop filter to get good audio. So that's it. That was the SE-X1. There's a link in the description to where you can buy it on Amazon. It's around £65 at the time of recording. And there's also a link to the isolation pack, which you can buy as an optional extra.